here is the coast and the harbor. The meager diet of horizon. Impractical scenery shaped with a harsh and dented fence between our sandy, marshy greenery. Camouflaged as a self-defense. The fun we'll have still remains to be seen. Because I invited you to take a break from your city chores on my shores. And all my whispers fell on deaf ears, confirming my fears. It all had seemed every bit as exciting and dangerous as my old school days had ever been. The danger, that's what draws me. That there was obviously a danger in us knowing each other. But now, even though this doesn't seem to be the case, curiosity and attraction have returned to me in front of your pictures. Like a planet dragged by the invisible nets of the sun. Incoming headache, drenched in cigarette smoke and cyan gin. Blue ink on the back of a wasted plank, like fading pink perfume. Move underneath, but watch out for the old fire. You'll never know if you don't try. And I wonder why the coldest air makes interference when we sleepwalk with dreams on our chests. The grandeur of a winter sky has convinced me to run away from despair. She's out there in clouds of lilac. And I am here, always waiting for yesterday to reoccur. As if we, as an item, never existed. Will I ever see him again? The negative answer hurts me, and the pain makes me want to sleep. But no one reaches out. Or do they shout? Am I so blind as to not find truth in anyone? I stood before a grassy valley. Beside a very tall and strangely deformed hill. It was steep enough to touch with the palm of your gloved hand, and the peak seemed impossible to reach for someone without wings. She reaches up to the cloudy sky, on top of a tree, innocent, curious, and free. Stretching as high as she can try, but there's a chasm in her moon. 1,030 times greater than the ocean. Its fervid opal froth-like freedom begs you, like I do, to snuff the candle, raise the amber, bask beguiled inside its frozen citadel. And burn the rhinestones of my long-lost love. Mask your shivers with its ascending steam. Summon your nightmares and dismantle my dream. Because the deepest sorrow within a hollow man is a wicked field where sadness grows fearless of drought. An only night wields a scythe of youth. For years it seemed we kept quiet, but it hasn't been more than a couple of months. Your curiosity had cooled. The warm breeze of post-summer flew through the gates. Each change in the moving air was caressing. It lingered like an idea, and suddenly vanished like rain in midday. Now and then I wrote, and again. I beg you. My words echoing on air and port, randomly yet inevitable, like squeaks on a basketball court. And perhaps they will not be received with the same glimmer as before. I am in the witch's place, filled with dread. My thoughts are with you, and I don't need to hide my words. My pride will not interfere in this cold grayness that dampens the air. I begged for forgiveness, though forgiveness for what I couldn't have said. What a sight for sore eyes you would be, and what a dinner we could have. Obviously, it would be wonderful to see you again soon. Your light shines brighter than a thousand suns, but I am stretched like the shore, pining to cup my palm lightly on your cold, uncovered shoulder and dust off morning frost from your emerald perfection. I will listen now, if you want to, if you can. You know what to do.